Hi, everyone. Welcome to the Kimberly Cloud Show. I'm your host, Kimberly Cloud. Wow. Do I have a special treat for you? So I would like to go into the history of why I decided to get it. And then I'll go into the questions that I wrote for myself. I got 56 minutes, so I'm going to make this work. Also, thank you to KCAA affiliates at NBC for making this possible. Thank you for your kind words. Thank you for helping me throughout this. Thank you for everything. So, with that being said, let's talk about what I'm getting. What I'm getting. So, I decided to get a BBL. I decided to get a BBL. Now, what is a BBL to some? A BBL is a Brazilian butt lift. Yes, I decided to get a Brazilian butt lift. If you don't already know, I decided to get this because I wanted to enhance and accentuate my look. Now, I am 40 years old. I just turned the big 40 July 3rd, 1984. And I said, you know what, I don't feel 40, but it's not that I'm trying not to feel 40, but I'm like, I should be a pretty good candidate for a Brazilian butt lift. So I talked to the doctor. I won't disclose the doctor's name till after the procedure, or I don't know if it's going to be the day of procedure or after the procedure. But this is a wonderful doctor. Now, nobody has never did what I did. Yes, they're on YouTube, but they have never got on NBC, affiliates of NBC, and talk about their journey. I have 10 days left. 10 days left until the 23rd. Now, let's talk about what else. Let's dig into more of why. Okay, I don't want to say abuse, but I will say that I have been mentally abused when it came to being smaller in shape than normal women. And so all my women out there that are thinking about getting it, I would say really do your research before you decide to get it. So find a doctor that you feel comfortable with. They're not just out to get your money. They're out to help you look better, have better self-esteem, all of that. So what else? Other than that, you know, I said to myself, you know what? I'm not doing it for other people. I'm doing it for myself because I would like to look better in clothing. As you know, people who know me, I have a small frame, but I have a stomach because I had 3 children via C-section. Now, when I get small, it goes down, but it don't always go all the way down, like the stomach area. I'm just being raw and uncut with this. My bum area is not very flat. It's like teardrop-ish, if we know what teardrop-ish is. That's not even a word, but teardrop-ish. And pretty much it has no apple curvature or normal voluptuous curvature to it. So I said to myself, okay, step one. I said, can I get it? I went to him. I said, can I get a Brazilian butt lift and a tummy tuck? He said, no, I don't want to put you through that. I'd rather you sit up there and get a BBL first and then come back to me for a tummy tuck. I said, okay. Okay. So we're going to do the BBL first. And I told him what I'm looking for and what I want to accentuate my body, how I wanted him to accentuate my body to look. So when the time is right to get the tummy tuck, I'll be ready to go. So, I have some questions, but before I get to the questions, I would like to talk to women about mental abuse between, and even men have mental abuse. get abused by women. And I would like to talk about abuse that causes people and bullying that causes people to want to go out there and get surgery. Because maybe 5 to 10% of 100%, you know, 5 to 10 out of 100% of me doing it is doing it because of the fact that I was mentally abused as a child for being small frame. And men get it too. You know, they're abused for, you know, different things. I won't go into detail, but they have reasons why they're being abused, you know, for control purposes, you know, for that person that's abusing the male to feel good about themselves and feel like they have power and control over the male or female. So what can we do about it? You know, if we don't, you know, we grow up looking at a lot of women who look the same, you know, Coca-Cola shaped bottle, the bum is voluptuous. Now, if that's what you want to do, then go ahead and do it. Do it, you know, but don't get pushed into doing it where somebody is telling you, you know, you should get it done because you don't look good as good with it, without it. Now, that's not what happened to me per se. My era of my boyfriends have done things uncontrollable that made me feel bad. And a lot of stars, Nicki Minaj, Cardi B, Lotto, and a lot more rappers and R&B stars, even Caucasian pop stars like Madonna and much more, they have gotten butt implants or butt lifts or butt shots, which is silicone mixed in with silicone mixed into the buttocks, your fake fat inserted into the buttocks, and they regret it. People push them into doing it because they thought that they would look pretty, which they do, but then their health started to decline. So do your research. Do not sit up there and do something like silicone shots because you feel as though Johnny is going to like it. And Johnny has been liking more women that's more voluptuous than me, so I might as well get it. Get these injections, not silicone, but liposuction. Get liposuction because you feel you want to accentuate your body. Nobody is making you fall off that plank. You are doing it. Mia Aesthetics is a good one. And the place that I'm going to is a good one, but I don't want to disclose it because I have one more thing to do with them. And, you know, I don't want nobody messing it up for me. But he's a wonderful doctor. We spoke yesterday. He told me the ins and outs. Do I have the questions that I asked him yesterday? No, I think I threw it away or it's in my book bag. But I asked him, would I look like, have my body snatched like normal women look? And he said, those women had tummy tucks and we're not trying to get a tummy tuck right away with you. We're trying to make sure the fat is in the body and then you have to wait 6 months to a year to get it. And by then, I should have the money to get the tummy tuck. I'll be 41, and I should have the money to get the tummy tuck and to, what else? Get the tummy tuck and to get more liposuction in my arm rolls and place it, all that fat that he's going to be sucking out of my stomach and out of my arm rolls into my buttocks again. And that's the plan. That is the plan. And I know a lot of people are like, well, why do you want to change your body? You know, just like having an abortion is a woman's choice. Getting surgery is a woman's choice. It's not harming nobody. That's why I don't get mad at Nikki or the rest of them for sitting up there having surgery. I don't even get mad at them. All I'm saying is that the silicone shots is very deadly. They can cause you to lose your buttocks. So, yeah. It's very serious to know who you're going to and what they're about. Like I said, Mia Aesthetics and the place that I'm going to is a great place to go to. Now, this is in the heart of Seattle. One day I will give up his name, but until then, I will not give up the name because of serious purposes. Now, today I will be talking about, I will ask 5 questions to myself. And I think that those questions are appropriate to the fact that we will be in hardcore discussion for at least 10 minutes each about each of them. And then if I finish early, I will go back to the bullying, which I want to go back to and say, if you're being bullied, you need to find somebody that's not bullying you and talk to them. Bully is unacceptable. They need to make laws on bullying. They really do. Because it causes, and then I'll move on. It causes people to either harm, assault, or severely hurt somebody, the bullyee being bullied, to the bully. It causes people to lash out at other people, to feel like they're in power, and they're confused. They get confused. They think that that's the way to go if they're being done, if it's being done at a young age. What else do they do? They sit up there and they continue. They try to commit suicide. They try to commit suicide. Or lastly, they're depressed all the time. So it's just not right. Some people can handle it at times, but not everyone. 100% of the people cannot handle it, but handle it at times. They may act like they're okay, but they put on a good show. So you put on quite a show, just like that song, except not in that context. So anyway, let's get to the questions. Why did I decide to have the surgery? It sounds redundant, like what I asked before, but I'll explain it in 10 to 15 minutes. Like I said before, back in the day, 5 to 10% of me, like every other person that has flat gluteus maximus and no actual fat down there, I was being picked on. I won't say who I was being picked on or why, because that's non-relevant. What's relevant is that it happened. What's relevant is that it happened. It happened to me. I used to go cry. I used to hear it being talked about literally while I'm sitting there. You know, I've had people show me pictures of women that have shapes, you know, like curvature shapes, and say, she looked better than you. I've had people slap other people on the gluteus maximus like I'm slow, like I, you know, it was just sickening what I went through. And so I dived. My story is, to be quite honest, I didn't let it get to me, but I did. So I dived into drugs. This is a whole new subject, but it's educational and it relates to some of the women out there. I dove into drugs, and you get numb when you're doing drugs. I won't go into what drugs I use, but you get very numb. You don't care. And then when the drugs come down, you care again. When you get back on them, you don't care. And when I dove into the drugs, it was a roller coaster ride for me for a while. And I decided this is not what I want to do. I need to learn other ways to cope with how I'm feeling. Now, mind you, a couple of hours ago, I know what to do, but we all have slip ups and we all rant to our friends, our family, behind the scenes. But whatever I do is in front of the scenes. I get in front of y'all to talk about what needs to be talked about that's on my mind. I don't have nobody here that I can talk about that to. And even if I did, I still would talk about it with y'all, because I think this is educational for y'all to know my ups and downs. Barely did I have a trigger. You give me a trigger, I don't know how to handle it. I'm trying to compute it, and I go off the wrong way. It happens, slip ups. So what do we do? You have to find your own niche and talk to a therapist or a doctor about ways to cope. There are ways to write down the do's, the don'ts, the pros, the cons. There are ways to check it, catch it, check it, and something else. Catch it and check it. I think those are the two things. Somebody gets you mad, you catch it and check it. Sometimes you don't want to catch it and check it. Sometimes you just want to go on a rant. But that's the educational part of catching it and checking it for women that have small butts, that wants to possibly get a Brazilian butt lift because they're being mentally abused. Get out of that toxic relationship, whether it's man or woman. Get out of that toxic relationship. Sometimes you have to prove yourself by getting out of it broke and build yourself up. Everybody has income. Everybody has a means of income, whether it's low income or high income. Save up. Don't smoke the cigarettes. Don't smoke weed if you can. And get out of, legal weed is fine with me, but get out of that toxic relationship. And then you start seeing it's going to be hard because you're used to having somebody cuddle with you. You're used to having somebody that you can talk to all the time. You're used to being their battle buddy and they being your battle buddy to your sight. They probably wasn't once you get out of that relationship. You know, somebody was more dependent on somebody. That's why it was most likely the person that's doing the abusing that's narcissistic. And then think about whether you want to get a Brazilian butt lift, butt implants, or some people still want to go with silicone shots. But it's more safer to get your own fat harvested and placed in your buttocks. Or not inside your buttocks, but your gluteus maximus. So, I wanted to talk about the things that I actually bought for a little bit. I should have got up and had them sitting right here, but I don't have them sitting right here, so I'm a little mad about that. So I bought a urination cup. It looks like a funnel cup, but it's made out of, not plastic, a type of rubber, like latex or something, like a type of hardened latex that can bend, something that can bend, and you place it at your faja. Let's go step by step. When you have a BBL, you wear something called a faja. A faja is something that they put, it's like a waist trainer, but it's not. It's a compression garment. You wear a board and you wear styrofoam cups. You wear styrofoam boards. Now, by wearing these things, that help compress the areas they did the lipo at and give you that hourglass shape from what they can do out of that. Now, let's see. When you urinate, you have that urination cup, and you squat. You don't squat like you squat in, you bending over and squat. You actually squat backwards, and you place that cup, you unzip down there, and you place that cup there, and you urinate. I don't want to know what happened with the number two, because nobody actually talks about it except one girl. She said you do the same thing, but I'm like, huh? I don't know. I don't want to know right now. That I'll be talking about it on my show after I get it. But there will be a lot of blood. But to actually maneuver back to the subject, because I want to get into that later. To remove it back to the subject, I say you find out what's your niche. You try to be on your own before thinking about getting any type of surgery. You try to figure out who is it that's bullying, because even family can bully. I won't get into detail. Even family can bully. I'll tell you that. Friends can bully. A lot of people can bully. Make you feel less than them. Because they got something that you don't got. Like, for instance, usually, to my people out there that listen to me, to KCAA, I usually wear wigs. Now, mind you, my hair was a lot longer. I decided to cut it down because I wanted to change the look that I have going on. And I'm having surgery, so this will be easy to maintain. Mind you, I can still wear wigs, but, you know, I may not wear it for a little bit, you know, so I can be, you know, free, you know. But to get to the point, some people may laugh at it, you know, and it may be different to other people, but they're learning how to work with it, you know. I did it for the surgery, and I did it because I want a short hairstyle. I actually want a texturizer, because this is my journey. This is what I want to talk about. I actually wanted a texturizer, and they gave me a texturizer, but my hair was still a little long and straight, so they cut some of it off because it was long. And I'm going to get another texturizer on the 4th of September, and that should bring in the curls, really. Because right now it's curly, but you can't really see that it's curly. So yeah, I'm going to get a texturizer, leave it on for 7-8 minutes. I've been doing my research, y'all. And then I have curly hair. And then if I feel like it, I may get it cut in the back again or let it grow out. I don't know. But I do want to dye it. I decided to dye it jet black again. And then just spray the top with red, copper, or some type of normalized spray. Nothing like blue, yellow, and purple. No. So don't laugh. So now the next question. How would the surgery be? The surgery, wow, this is a hard one. The surgery will be very good. You know, it's going to be painful. I have to admit, it will be very painful. And I will explain to those who's just joining the show how the fat transfer process works. So let's say the air, A-I-R, is the space in between here. Here's the muscle. here's the fat, and here's the skin. They go in, they do what they do to get all that fat out. They rinse it with a rinse, and then that causes inflammation, but it's normal. So now we got inflammation is the space. Now we need massages. We need massages. What massages do is you massage out the fluids that they put in there, and that's inflamed. When something get inflamed, fluid starts to fill. Whether you get something put in you or not, fluid starts to fill up. You hit yourself with an elbow, fluid starts to fill up real hard. You have to do it real hard, but fluid starts to fill up and it starts to become a knot around there, a knot in fluid and swelling. And that's what the doctors want. They want the swelling because that shows the fact that it's actually the process of healing. The process is healing. And so we got that healing. And you take your antibiotics. I got my antibiotics. I got my nausea medicine that's going to go right behind my ear. Another reason I have to take off my wig and then put it back on. It makes no sense. So, because I don't glue my wig on. So the nausea medicine is going to go behind, the patch is going to go behind my ear. I take Zofran or whatever that crap is called, the pills, if I'm still nauseated. You have to wash your hand thoroughly when you take it off, they said, because it can blind you if you try to take it off, don't wash, and put it in your eyes accidentally. And Seneca and something else, it's another over-the-counter medicine, one for inflammation, one for pain. I have gabapentin that I can take still. I have to discontinue ibuprofen, which I did today because it's 10 days. I'm taking Tylenol, and pretty much I'm doing everything that I can to maintain. And like I said, it's not going to be a hop, skip, or the jump where I'm like, hey, everybody, welcome to the Kimberly Cloud Show. I feel great. No, it ain't going to be like that, or it's not going to be like that. I'm going to be really in pain, and I'm not going to be able to edit, but I will be able to. It's a good day of the surgery because what I can do is edit a video. No, I have to start picking back up the pieces by Thursday. So that's Friday. So 5 days after surgery, I should be able to start picking up the pieces. And what I mean by that is doing my homework by Thursday. Thursday at 12 a.m. I have until then. And I'm not going to wait till the last minute. I'm actually going to wait until Wednesday because I don't want to sit up there and be behind in this class. I do my homework, get in, get out. I don't sit up there and get mad or butt hurt if she don't write me back. I don't care. As long as I do my work and I get my grade, that's it. So I just want to get my grade. I do what I need to do to get my grade. I don't do no more extra. I don't get invested like emotionally. Some people be like, why won't you write me back? I don't care. So it is what it is. So anyway, do my work by Wednesday and do my project by Saturday. And I won't be editing no videos next week. I won't edit no video. I'll focus on getting together because it's going to be hard putting on a faja. And then by next Friday or the Monday after next Friday, I will be in my stage 2 faja, which is even more compressed than the first one. And then they take out the board. So I've been doing my research a lot. And I have to get a massage the week prior. Usually, if you get a tummy tuck, you get a massage like the day after. Now, when I get this tummy tuck next year, I don't know what date. I don't want to give a date. But when I get the tummy tuck next year, what I want to do is I want to have a nurse on call for 5 days. 5 days. That way, I will be able to, move around better. I mean, I've done 3 C-sections. Like I said, I have C-sections and my plication or whatever you call it is like I'm out of shape. I'm out of shape, but I don't have a high BMI. I am a high BMI, but I'm not as high as some people are when they get in their surgery. But my stomach muscles are not together. They're like unbulging or whatever the case may be. And he has to sew them back together and make them into a muscle and then take off the fat, bring the fat down, which is going to get rid of my stretch marks, y'all, from having the babies. Oh, my God. And, yeah, I'm going to be very happy and no real eating. You know, will I go for a round 3 if something bad happens? Heck yes, I will. It is not fun to get it. I haven't gotten it yet, but I've gotten major surgeries before. Like the 3 C-sections, they go past the muscle into the uterus, and that's more pain. So I probably could tolerate it by myself, but I'm not going to chance it. Plus another BBL, I cannot chance this because I don't want me to be on the floor like, help me. And nobody can help me. You know, I want to have a nurse on call or a nurse there with me at least 10 hours or 6 hours of the day. I'll split it up. The first day, 24 hours. The rest of the day, 5 to 6 hours. That's how it should be. So, next question. Hold up. Sorry. When will the surgery be? Well, the surgery will be on the 23rd of this month at 8 a.m. I will film as much as my pain level can take. I knew I was going to mess up somewhere. And I will be sure to let you guys see the downright everything. See everything. I wanted to say something else, but I paused and said something else on top of something else. But the bloody, the gory, everything. I want to show y'all everything. So if y'all want to get one, because there's always somebody out there that wants to get one, you know. It's always somebody that's curious. And, you know, next Tuesday, I will probably be on here. Well, I will be on here talking about I have 3 days before surgery. Now, I bought a table so I can stand, but I probably won't stand that long with the NBC and probably do a skit of, you know, I'll stand and wear not tight fitting garment, but a garment that can accentuate my shape on the 27th. I think the 27th is the Tuesday after that. Let me see. Yeah, the 27th. So on the 27th, I probably stand most likely. And that will be how many weeks? Hold on. Hold on, y'all. Hold on, Lucy. 1, 2. That'll be my 2-week post-op. Wait. No. Sorry, y'all. I'm wasting raw footage. That'll be just a couple of days. I'm sorry. I went from the 13th. It'll be 2 weeks in on the 27th from the 13th. But I have an appointment with them on the 26th. Now, let me tell you guys. I will have to not drive, but catch an Uber all the way to the clinic. And that's like $43 one way. And I'm like, oh my God, what's going on? I was so saddened by that. That's $43 one way, and it's 6 treatments of massage, lymphatic massages. Lymphatic massages is when they, like I was telling y'all before, they take the fluids out, which makes the skin stick to the muscle more. But yeah, man, from the 23rd, that's 4 days. So I'll most likely be standing just a little bit and probably make it a 15 to 30 minute show and show y'all how I look afterwards. Now, I'm not going to look like none of these women that then snuck and got tummy tucks and pretend like they just got a BBL. I'm not getting a tummy tuck right now. So I still have a little mini stomach. But I will still have what we agreed upon, me and the doctor, the buttocks. And I'll wait like a year or 9 months to 6 months to get the tummy tuck. And I want to be... I'm going to ask them if we can get reevaluated after 6 months. That way I have a total of what he thinks should be done then and not then, if that makes any sense. It makes sense to me. So 4 days, 5, 6, 7, 8. 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. The 6th of September will be the 14th. And now we're reaching over into more time that I'm going to have off. Or I probably won't even do time off. Because I have to go October the 12th to Texas for a... graduation, to graduate. It's an official graduation, but I won't get my actual degree until December. I get my degree sent in the mail, probably early January, late December. So yeah, I'm happy about that. And I have my little mini shape, not a lot, just a little. And give me a second. Will you achieve your results? No, I will not, like I said before, achieve the final results I'm looking for. Next year I will go in and have some reconstructive things going on, such as a tummy tuck, bra roll, fat sucked out of it, and placing it into the buttocks again and the tummy tuck. So yeah, around the same time, I will need a nurse for approximately a week, like I said. As long as I get the achieved results I paid for, I'm good. I know what I can't get. I know what the results might look like. All online, which boggles my mind, I see girls with high BMIs and low BMIs that have bellies that had... BBLs and tummy tucks, and there's not one girl online that actually shows herself, which I will only in my skivvies. I'm not getting out my skivvies showing no belly. I'm just saying I will sit up there and with the faja on, I will sit up there and show my body on a picture, and maybe I can do, I have to do a Brains Magazine skit. I know they're waiting on me to send it in. I may do two back to back. That's probably what I'll do, two back to back, because I have one that's old this month and one that's coming up next month, because we're almost in the middle of the month. And yeah, so back to achieve the results. No, I will not. But let's talk about something else, because we're almost finished. Okay. I know CNN, CBS, NBC, Sky News, LOL. I put Sky News, LOL, because they're like, why is this girl hashtagging us? ABC, My Journey with BBL, KCAA, you know why. So anyway, I wanted to say, I also got, I got maxi pads. Let me tell you what you need, child. Maxi pads to cover your scars and cover your genital areas from the faja scratching it. I have band-aids for that too, once it stops seeping out. Like stuff that look like a doggy pad. What else? A washcloth to give myself a sponge bath, and a spray bottle to spray it with warm water so I can wipe off the blood, the excess blood. My prescriptions, what else? I'm looking. Genital wipes for your genital area. Medical tape, a shower curtain, iPads for your eye, toothbrush, toothpaste. Can't leave without my toothbrush, toothpaste. Don't want no stinky breath. And what's in the bathroom is a soap that they give you at this specific clinic to sit up there and what do they do? They want you to scrub it. They don't tell me to scrub with Dial soap, but I bought some Dial soap too for the sponge bath. I bought a washcloth too. And they told me to get some, they didn't tell me to get nothing. I got it on my own. I looked it up. And I'm gonna get a BBL pillow too. They give you a BBL pillow, but I'm gonna get another BBL pillow. And I'm gonna get some type of blow up bed so my butt can hang down on the circle. And I can just be on the floor looking at TV, because it's hard to look at TV. Or I could just, no, I can't. I was going to say move my bed around, but my bed is mechanic. It's like one of them old school beds that you can prop it up or you can sit it down. And this one go 360. No, I'm just kidding. So, I probably buy carpet, because I have wood floors. So I probably buy like a certain inch carpet to be mailed to me and stuff. And if it gets dirty, I just sweep it off. I got like a mechanical mop. I got water in my trunk, two cases of water, big cases of water. And my male nurse, I don't care what the race is, but my male nurse, he can bring that up and we can go shopping together for like a week worth of stuff until I get paid again. And then I should be able to go by myself. No, I can't do that, because they said that's not good. I was supposed to talk to Miss the lady about hiring somebody for an hour out of the time for me to go take a shower and put on my faja and then probably cook. I don't know. But I want to make this work. I just want to make it work. I talked to my doctor about getting a massage at Zeal. Zeal, they'll come out to you versus you. You know, I guess they bring the items with them, like the table and everything. And Zeal will come out to you and massage you. And I have the doggy pads. I have to buy some more because it's not enough. and I got enough pads to last me for at least a week or two. And that's basically it. You know, I need to go grocery shopping. One time while before, just small grocery shopping, and go grocery shopping right after. I got a whole chicken. See, the food that I cook, what time is it? The food that I cook lasts like a week, but I like snacks, and I have to give those up for more healthy alternatives, which I have done before. So I'm gonna buy some tuna fish, but I like to eat sweet stuff. So I'm gonna switch it up, pineapples. I'm gonna start making smoothies at my house. Instead of going off buying smoothies, buying smoothies, I'm gonna make my own smoothies. I'm gonna buy some pineapples, frozen and fresh. I don't know if I want frozen fresh. But either way though, I'm gonna buy some pineapples. And I have protein shake. I have protein powder. I'm gonna buy some more. I have polyglycol 3350, which is laxatives, like normalized laxatives. I put that in there with the protein. And I have some type of energy drink to work post-workout. I used to take it all the time. I may do that. I may do a chocolate one. I got to get used to washing that thing. That's why I stopped. I don't like dirty nothing, you know, but I like chocolate smoothies. I put banana, chocolate, and peanut butter. Oh, my God, those used to be the best. But I won't get my body prepared yet until after the surgery, day 5. And I'll turn around all my computers so you guys can see me make the smoothie. I have a studio. I don't have no it's luxurious to me. It's very clean and it's very, security is high, and I'm blessed. Whether I was living on the street or not is irrelevant, but I'm blessed right now. And so 7 minutes left. Oh, sorry. So anyway, every time I think about something, I itch. So anyway, that last question, will you need a nurse after the surgery? Yes. Only for 24 hours will I pay for a nurse. Now I'm going to work something out with the young lady or the lady at the place that I'm going to see what prices she can give me for them to come over from an hour to an hour and a half. So I answer my own question to help me with the basic things like getting up and much more continuation. But no pain, no gain. I've been in the military. I'm able to take pain to a certain extent. Only pain I cannot take is electrical pain. And that's what you get when you have a C-section. I don't know if you get that when you have, a tummy tuck or not. But I had electrical pain, and it was terrible. 5 minutes. So, in closing, I would like to tell you guys that, is that 6 or 5? 5. I would like to tell you guys that if you're really thinking about getting a BBL, make sure that you do your research. Make sure that you go out there and you talk to your family that aren't bullies, talk to your family that are working with you, have a family member, have a somebody there that can help you through this process. If you don't have any family, order a nurse or go to a nursing home which does surgical nursing for surgical procedures. And in Miami at Mia Aesthetics, they have like homes for people that after post-surgery. So you have your options, and this is going to be an exciting experience for me, and I cannot wait for it to work. So you guys have a wonderful, wonderful day, and I'll be back on here later, but you take care, KCAA. Thank you for everything, and take care, NBC. Take care to the CEO of KCAA for making this possible. I will see you guys another time. Bye.